Hi friends, my name is Akil Ahmed, and in this particular video tutorial we will talk about checkpoints in SSIS. So this is my profile. I have 9 plus years of experience on Microsoft technologies, mainly in SSIS and SQL Server. So the agenda of today's video tutorial is what are checkpoints in SSIS and then how to configure the checkpoints for an SSIS package. So you can think of checkpoints as a way to restart the SSIS package from the point where it got failed. Okay, in real life scenarios, an SSIS package can fail due to n number of reasons. So one of the reason might be that the file that it loads doesn't exist at a particular location, or maybe the file is corrupt, or maybe the server went out of its space. So you know, in these kind of scenarios we need to restart the SSIS package. So sometimes a package can be kind of lengthy and it do n number of work. So every time we restart the package, package start running from the very beginning. So for example, there is an SSIS package that loads a huge file, and after that it does some updates on second and third step. Then so if the package got failed at the second step while updating the data, then it should not load the file again, because the file has already been loaded and it's a big file, so it should be restarted from the second option. So we will see how we can do that using the checkpoint. So without wasting time, let's jump to the demo. So I'm going to create an SSIS package in the Visual Studio 2013. So let me open the SQL Server Data Tools 2013, and then let me create an SSIS package. So our SSIS package will actually load a CSV file which contains 1000 number of records, and then it will do some updates on second step and some more update on third step. So in case the file fails at second step after loading the file, then when the SSIS package will run, it should not reload the file again. Okay, so we will see that. So let's create a new SSIS package. I can name the package as checkpoint usage, and then okay, so it will create a blank project. Okay, so the blank SSIS package has been created, and now let's open the SQL Server Management Studio. So I have SQL Server 2016 Developer Edition installed on my machine, and I have a database, testing database, which currently doesn't contain any table in it. Okay, so we will create a blank table, customer data, in the SSIS package itself, and then we will load data from this particular file, testdata.csv. So this particular table actually contains some customer data. So we will load this particular data, which currently has 1000 number of lines to this particular table, customer data, and then we will run some updates on it in second step, and in third step we will also do some updates. Okay, and then we will try to fail the SSIS package at this step, second step, so that we can restart the package, you know, from this point only. So what we can do, we can drag and drop an execute SQL task which will actually create the SQL Server table if the SQL Server table doesn't exist. Okay, so let me name the task as create customer data. Okay, and then let me make a connection to the SQL Server. So click new connection, new. My SQL Server name is developer SQL 2016, and the database name is testing. Okay, so click test connection. Connection is successful. Click OK. Okay. And now what we can do, we can simply copy and paste this particular code to the execute SQL task, so that whenever the SSIS package will run, this table will be recreated every time. Okay. And now let's drag and drop data flow task so that it can actually load customer data from the CSV file. Load CSV file. Okay. And then we can use the flat file source so that it can read the CSV file and load it to a SQL Server table. So double click flat file source, click new, and then let's browse the CSV file, change it to CSV files, test data. Okay, preview. So data looks good here. Click OK. Okay, and now we can use an OLEDB destination to load the data to a SQL Server table. Double click OLEDB destination, and then we can select the table from here. So table doesn't exist as of now. So what we can do, we can actually, you know, create this particular table. Okay, so now there should be a Okay, sorry. Actually, the table got created inside the master database. So let me change it to testing. Okay, and now let me create the table again. Okay, so now table will be inside the customer data. And now what we can do? We can select the customer data table from here, and then we can navigate to my things to make sure that the input columns have been met the destination column. So this seems good. Okay, and now we can click OK. So this can load the CSV file. Now what we can do, so this kind of first step that we are creating a table and then we are loading some data into it, and then in second step we will actually update the data. So we will change the company name to uppercase. Okay, so there is a field company name and we will change the casing of that particular column. Okay, so select the database testing, and then we can put this particular query inside this particular SQL statement. Okay, so this is second step, and now let's create a third step as well. So this I'm just showing this to show some steps, otherwise we can also put all the SQL update statement inside the single SQL execute SQL task as well. But in real life scenario it won't be 1000 records, there can be millions of records, sometimes 100 million or 5000 million. There can be lots of data inside it. So right now if I will rerun this package, then it won't make much difference while running the package from this point or from the starting, because data is not that much huge. But in real life scenario, if you are loading maybe 100 million records and then you are doing some transformation in between, maybe you are calling some API, then it makes difference while running the package from scratch or while running the package from the point of state where it actually got failed. So let me just write the second update statement inside this execute SQL task, which is change gender to lowercase. Okay, and then make a connection to the SQL Server database. Okay, and then put the update query here in the third step. Okay, so we are dropping table, loading data, doing some update, and then doing another update. So right now if you will execute this particular package, so the package should run successfully, because there is not any issue in the SSIS package and it should have loaded 1000 records. Okay, but in real life scenario when a SSIS package runs, so there can be several reasons that the package can fail at a particular point of time. So what we can do, we can forcefully fail this particular SSIS package at this particular location. Let me just put in maybe a keyword, maybe A, so that it can fail at this particular state. When we will rerun this particular package, so it should rerun the package from this particular task only. It should not reload the data again. Okay, so now what we need to do, right click on the SSIS package and navigate to properties, and then scroll to up, and then there is a property checkpoint. So what we need to do is, we need to change the save checkpoints to true. Checkpoint use save checkpoints to true means whenever the SSIS package will run, it will actually save the checkpoint information to an XML file. Okay, and then when we will run the SSIS package next time, so it will look for the XML file and it will read the information where the SSIS package got failed from the XML file, and will rerun that SSIS package from that point only, where it was actually got failed. And when it will run successfully, so it will delete the XML file, so next time it won't find any XML file, and then it can run the package from that point, that particular point itself. Okay, checkpoint usage, so we need to change it to if exists. So for example, if checkpoint file will be there, then it will read the information where to run the SSIS package from the checkpoint file. Otherwise, if it won't find any checkpoint file, then when the SSIS package will run from the starting point, and there is a checkpoint file name. So what we need to do is, we can create an XML file here and name it maybe checkpoint file. Okay, and then kind of XML, the extension is XML. Okay, and now we can browse the file, and so what will happen when the SSIS package will run, it will save the information to this particular checkpoint file. So right now this particular file is empty, okay, because we just recreated it as a blank file, so it doesn't contain any information as of now. Okay, so it's a blank file, And now, okay, so we have set these checkpoints properties for the SSIS package, and now select all the tasks inside the SSIS package, and then look for the property fail package on failure. Okay, so fail package on failure. So this property should be set to true. Okay, so once you will set this property fail package on failure to true, then we are good here. And now what we can do, we can run the SSIS package. So the SSIS package got failed at the third step. And if you go back to the XML file, so you will see that this XML file now has some data, and maybe you can open this file in Internet Explorer, and now you can see that it contains some information like on which task it got failed, and it contains the ID of that particular task. Okay, so now what we need to do is, okay, so now let's fix this particular issue and remove the A from here so that the package can run fine. Click OK. Okay, so now when we will rerun this particular SSIS package, so it should be run from this particular SSIS package only. It should not reload the file again. Okay, so let's, you know, stop the debugging, and then let's restart this particular SSIS package. And now you can see that it skipped first two tasks, and then it ran from the point where it got failed actually. Okay, so this can actually save lots of time in real life scenarios. And if you will recheck, so you will see that the XML file has been deleted because the package ran successfully, so it has deleted the XML file. And now if you will rerun the SSIS package, so it will run from the first task. So let me rerun this package again, so you know it will run from the first task. So guys, this is how we can use the checkpoints in the SSIS package and can save lots of time. Thanks guys for watching the video, and if you like the video, then please click the like button and do subscribe to our channel to see more videos on SSIS and other related technologies. Thank you so much.